See how much time we got, Jeff, before you start? That means I got to be careful what I say.
That stream is active. If you, I want to make sure we could get it. And the stream is hot. Anybody joining us, you're looking live at Thomasville High School. We're awaiting the teacher recognition night. You're going to watch Thomasville and Pelham live here on Insights, High School Sports Game of the Week. Jeff Walker along with Coach Mickey Clayton.
Jeff Walker, how are you, sir?
I'm excellent. Coach Clayton, legendary Rattler, the Bobby Knight of black college basketball.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
I wish I'd have been a journalism student when you were coaching.
I was an easy interview.
No, I would have kept the camera on you. I'd have kept the camera on you. We would have had Instagram video for days. Watch Coach Clayton, the referees.
Look at you.
Thomasville teachers being recognized.
Is that all the teachers? Boy, some of the basketball players look like they don't know them teachers.
It's a good idea. More schools should do that. That's an excellent idea. Recognize the teachers, folks who are in the trenches. I'd like to personally thank all of my teachers. I had some excellent teachers. I mean some world-class teachers. Matter of fact, one comes to mind is Eileen Warner. She passed away years ago, but worked a job at FAMU DRS. She could have gone anywhere and been making in the county as a 30-year teacher. She should have been at least at the 100 grand mark, but she stayed and wanted to sow into our lives. A huge thank you to Ms. Warner and her husband, Mr. Warner, who was there with her for years. So,
well, she should have got $100,000 just for being your teacher. That in itself was worth hazardous pay.
Yeah, it was an adventure. I could only imagine if I'd had social media back then to roast the teachers like the students do now.
Oh, they said each one of the basketball players got an opportunity to pick the instructor that influenced them the most. And my boy got Reggie Perry.
Reggie Perry and Coach Gray.
Yeah, he got the football coach.
Yeah, total fire and ice.
Right.
Reggie, a laid back, cool, collective guy. Coach Gray's pure fire.
Now you're right about that.
Maybe some of that Grage needs to rub off on him.
See, there you go.
Get him a little.
Thank you, teachers, coaches, and staff for all that you do to help our young men and young women.
Another one of my teachers, excellent teacher, Miss Doris Medlock. Have to mention her. Mr. Holt, Harry K. Holt.
That was actually really good there for them to do that.
Yes, sir.
That was really good.
Yes, sir. I wouldn't be sitting where I'm sitting had it been for some world-class. I had world-class instructors.
Jeff, you don't have to keep saying that. We know they were world-class if they helped you. They passed the ultimate test.
Yeah, they passed a huge test. And most of them will attest to it.
I'm sure they would. No doubt about it.
I'm sure they prayed a lot of they shouted when I graduated. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh boy, I'm sure of that, Jeff. I have no doubt whatsoever.
Yes, sir. So it looks like we're gonna have 14 minutes and 44 seconds until the game kicks off. But until then, live listeners, watchers out there, we'll send a shout out to the folks in Abu Dhabi listening to us. Insights, what do you call that thing when they track the watchers and that sort of thing? They call it the analytics.
Jeff, you just create stuff And then you ask me to bail you out once you get out far.
No, the insight analytics, the analytics that they use to track watchers, listeners, and viewers. You have a strong following in Abu Dhabi. Thomasville comes out to the Migos. Here come the Pelham Hornets.
Well, at least you got the name right.
Thought they were Yellow Jackets.
Yes, you did.
But it says, see there, thank my teachers, I can read Hornets basketball. Pelham looks like they have a little size. Got a couple of kids, 6'8", 6'5". I think while I still can grow hair, I'm going to grow my hair out so I can get the little dreads. Seems to be quite popular.
What did they put in your nachos and cheese? They put something in it.
We're going to start our pregame show at 7 minutes. 7 minutes. We're 5 minutes and 22 seconds away.
Isn't she walking like right in front of your camera?
Yeah, but it's okay.
Okay.
Always a pleasure coming to Thomasville.
I'm sure.
Yep. It's the closest church is chicken within a couple of, since they closed the last churches in Tallahassee. Used to enjoy going over there on Lake Bradford.
I'm not mad about that that chicken over there. Give me a couple of wings and one of those butter biscuits.
I'm gonna tell you where they have some outstanding chicken. Boy, right up the road in Blakely. If you ever go through Blakely, you got to stop at Blakely Chicken. Yep. Always an adventure here. Four minutes to the pregame show. Still much bigger. Looks like they had bigger bodies this year. All is ice. I'm my own jeweler. Six lawyers. I'm the star. My movie. My kids listen to that. That's the only reason why I know the words. Ran off on the plug twice. Steady calling, I ain't calling Mike. Woo! Born. You got confirmation? It's on?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's okay. That's why it's video on demand. But give it about 30 minutes. Everything on me brand new. Mm-hmm.
It says live.
Yes, sir. It is live. That is, well, you're probably buffered out, but no problem. If you, it'll, let me see. Well, they just do it on another level at Gobby and Rickards. Thomasville's got a little sound system, but they don't have the subs like the Raiders and the Cougars. They just saw DJ King Green told him that DJ Little Boy laid it down at the Gobby game. He said, "Don't worry, he's gonna bring it when they come over to the Raiders headquarters." DJ King Green said, "You could expect it." He said, "It's gonna be all the way live." 1 minute, 30 seconds to, let me see what we have here. Okay, Google, show me the live insight stream. He said he's gonna bring it. He said, "Yeah, I heard you." It's amazing when you sneak diss somebody, everybody hears you. they hear that. Yeah, I heard you talk about me.
Uh-oh.
Absolutely. Yeah. All right, let me start the recorder up, sir. For those of you watching live, we're getting ready to go into our Insights Game of the Week live in 4, 3, 2. We are rolling.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Insights High School Game of the Week. You're here today with the coach, Mickey Clayton, and Jefferson Slick Rick Walker.
Slick Rick. I'd rather be Jefferson Plies. They call it like Plies. Give me one of the new rappers.
Okay.
Jefferson's 2 Chainz, you know. Hell, Jefferson Sneak Diss Walker.
Oh, we're here today. And what should prove to be a very exciting contest, we got a rematch already. Thomasville High Bulldogs and the Pelham Hornets. They played December 12th. Thomasville was able to pull out a 55-48 game, and what the athletic director said was a sloppy affair.
Wow.
And we got a rematch in here tonight. We got Thomasville High. They're rolling in here with a 15-2 record, ranked 3rd in the state. Pelham High with a 13-3 record. They're ranked 7th in the state.
You know, it's going to be a battle, and you got the powerhouse recruit, Reggie Perry. I'm very anxious to see. Very anxious to see what the Bulldogs are going to dial up to see if they can go 16-2.
Well, we saw Thomasville earlier. You were dealing with what you were dealing with, and we missed you. We saw them earlier in the year when they played Cairo.
Yeah.
And they are a much better team than what they were last year. They're still very young. Not very young, but still young. We were able to see the maturity and the growth in the team. They had a swagger to them that they didn't have last year. They were trying to feel their way around, and they were all Reggie Perry. But the guards that you like are getting after, they're long, they're athletic, they apply a lot of pressure. They just have a lot of confidence in themselves. They brought a young man up off the JV team. We were looking for your favorite, Kurt Rambis.
And, I see him out there.
You know, he doesn't wear glasses now.
I see Sam. I see him out there. He's looking good. Looks like he lost a little weight.
He did. But the kid they brought up off the JV team brought him an outside shooter. He's able to knock down some shots for him. So okay. they're a better team, and they're getting it done. So it'll be an interesting game.
Yeah. Pelham's gonna have to run the floor. And they're gonna have to put a body on Perry. You know, you know, depending on which you know, if aggressive Reggie shows up tonight, which we're hoping to see, or, you know, Reggie was very passive last year when we saw him in the Rickards game. We saw him in 2-3 games, and he was a little passive. So I'm curious, you know, I want to see him come out, be aggressive, take over, you know, go for 100, you know.
Well, I don't know about putting a body on him. Once they put him in the block in Carroll, he was able to score. But he, you know, he kind of plays on the perimeter. He handles the ball well, shoots from the perimeter, multi-talented, able to do more than one thing. So it's a little interesting in terms of the ability that he has. I mean, he just, I don't really think it's in his personality to kind of be that way.
Right.
He's he can do whatever he needs to do to win. He's multi-talented.
Yeah. And, Thomasville's got to play. They got to bring their A game, and I'm sure this will have district or regional implications, you know, going down the line.
No, it's going to be a good game. It's one of the reasons that we selected it as one of the games that we wanted to televise and bring to the community and to highlight Thomasville High. This was a game that we thought that should be a good game. So we're excited about having that opportunity.
All right.
And this is Insights High School Game of the Week. And their take that we had the referees with them at the middle of half court. Thomasville's team standing there in a half circle, I guess, in support of their coaches, in support of their team captains. But we're going to be right back, and we'll take a break.
I was saying, stop your YouTube. It's slowing the Wi-Fi down. Thank you, sir.
Done.
All right, ready?
Ready. And the countdown is on. With about 30 seconds left before the tip-off. Insights High School Game of the Week with the coach. And with Slick Rick Jeff Walker. He looks good over there with those headphones with Insights all over him. What?
Yeah, we're 19 seconds till the national anthem. Like I said, Thomas,
how do you know they're doing the national anthem?
Wild guess. I don't know.
Okay, I was looking for the ROTC or something. I said maybe Jeff knows something I don't know. Which would not be the first time.
Looks like we're gonna do starting lineups.
We haven't had this much this season.
Yeah, you know what? I really enjoy these semi-rival games. I know it's not Thomasville and Bainbridge or Thomasville and Cairo, but Pelham might as well be a rival because they're right there.
That's the leading score right there for Pelham. That's DeJuan Jones, averaging almost 15 points a game, 5'11" senior.
DeJuan Jones, we're going to keep our eye on Jones.
We got Tron Pace, number two, is a 5'11" junior. Kentarius Bird, 6'4" junior. Number five, Daryl Starlin, 6'1" sophomore. And Kendrick Patterson, leading rebounder, 6'4" sophomore.
Here comes Thomasville. Thomasville, like you said before, 16 and 2.
Number 10, Quindarius Thomas, long guard. Luke Wallace was on the JV last year, from what I understand, shoots the ball pretty good. 22, Titus Wright is the guy, the big body that's inside. It's gotten better in there.
Yeah.
Hard to keep off the glass, very physical, nice drop step. Still needs a little work, he's a junior. And you got Reggie Perry, who is the main, one of the top five recruits in the state of Georgia. Many have him as the number one player in the state of Georgia.
Yeah, a lot of people were on me last year when I called him Reggie and the Miracles, because without Reggie in the game we saw, they took him out of the game and they just went, Thomasville went ice cold, actually in two of the games that we covered. So yeah, Reggie's gonna jump center.
That surprises you? Thomasville wins the tip.
Controls the tip.
2-3 zone.
Carries it. Bring him up to the top.
That's where he played last year. Alley-oop.
Alley-oop. He overthrows it. Boy, they had it. Seems like that should be the other way around. 10 should be throwing the alley-oop to Reggie. Thomasville with a full court press. Pelham got a 5 count already. Brings it up. Thomasville's man-to-man. Pelham's looking for something. They haven't. They still got the ball out here way at the top of the key. They can't get anything down low. There's a shot by number one. It's off the mark. Rebound, Reggie Perry.
Leading scorer, DeJuan Jones takes the three.
Perry asks for the ball. Pass it to in and out.
Yeah. That's the one they have to
there
keep off
is.
The board.
Like you said, offensive rebound. There's Perry with a long three. Misses. You're going to get a foul on number 15 for the Bulldogs.
That's Quindarius Thomas took that first jumper out the corner there.
And he is their leading scorer, correct? Like you said.
No. That's Quindarius Thomas is with Thomasville.
Okay.
I thought he was going to pick that ball up crossing half court. Skip pass.
Perry is on their leading scorer. He drives to the hoop and scores. That's number 4 for the Pelham Hornets.
That's Quindarius Bird going to the free throw line.
Nice move.
Pelham on the board first.
Pelham's up 2-0.
Ugly for this is, wow, he got wow. that. He tried to tip it in and Reggie blocked it from behind him.
Wow.
But I don't know how he got in front of Reggie to begin with.
Yeah, he did a kind of a spin around, a whirly bird around Reggie's block out and got in front of him.
Thomas 3-1 with motion.
What a bad pass.
Yes, it was.
Trying to get it in there. Bad pass. Pelham brings it up. Pelham's up 2-0.
Patient in the offense. And that's a block shot. And we'll take a break and come right back.
All right.
And the ball is in play. Look like they lined up in a 2-3 and then matched to a man coming out of it. They do a pretty good job in their man-to-man.
Hell, I'm working the glass.
Pelham does not seem to be intimidated at all.
Thomasville coach yelling to the point guard, telling him, hey, set the offense. Perry with the push. Yeah, he was aggressive there.
He was aggressive there. Actually, I like that move. I thought that call actually could have gone either way, but I like that move. A little more aggressive than normal.
Thomasville still with this full court press. Pelham at 5 count. They get it across at 7. In the corner again. The knuckleball 3-pointer. Thomasville pushes.
Oh, that's a dangerous pass. It's a dangerous pass and a turnover.
Yeah.
No, it's not a turnover.
The Pelham players know that they want to get Reggie involved. So they're kind of they're cheating to him defensively. See there. 3-pointer. They left him wide open because everybody was looking at Reggie.
Quindarius Thomas, corner jump shooter.
Thomas hit, and everybody was looking at Reggie, and Thomas was wide open. No look pass.
The middle of that zone press is where the weakness is. Good pass inside.
Oh, good.
That's four fouls on Thomasville. They're going to be shooting two. Insight's high school game of the week. We'll be back to get these free throws.
I wish these people would sit down somewhere. It's okay. We're back.
Nice free throw.
Nice one. Makes the first. Pelham's up 5-3. Pelham makes a sub. They got another sub coming in for the shooter.
They're going to have to convert these free throws if they're going to look to win this one. Titus Wright is out.
Wonder what is the strategy with you work Perry to the middle.
Turnaround coming.
We got a push.
Well, that's the first foul on Pelham. It's four fouls to one.
Sub in for. Everybody's loving that dread with the low, with the clean cut.
Well, they're getting a little physical underneath.
Thomasville. Nice interior pass. Back out for a three. He's off the mark. Going to get another foul on Thomasville. Well, they got to be careful. They're going to put him in the bonus. We've only been playing.
Wow, 4 minutes.
4 minutes of actual running time.
Real patient, two guard front offense on the two guard, on the 2-2-1.
Passed into the trap.
Yeah, but he hooked him and came out of it.
There's a shooter. He drives in. Wow, Perry just too much size in there.
He's on
the floor.
That wasn't close the way he was able to rebound. He had his elbows above him. He's a little more aggressive in there. I mean, he's exerting himself on the glass a little more. You're seeing the potential that everybody knew that he had that we didn't always see when we saw him play. We just saw the potential.
Each one of the Pelham players is looking at Reggie Perry. They want to know where he is at all times.
I'm sure their coaches enforce that on him.
Yeah.
A time or two.
Somebody else has got to step up. To become not turn the ball over like they just did. Somebody's got to step up and become a threat to take the heat off of it. Pelham worked it in tight. That was too easy.
Sure was.
Like I said,
7-3.
Somebody,
3 minutes left.
Somebody's got to step up because. Reggie's running that zone. You're running.
Running that baseline.
Running the baseline, trying to get in. Another off mark.
Oh, nice rebound.
Nice rebound.
Nice rebound.
They're going to get a jump ball.
Yeah, a jump ball call.
Thomasville struggling early. Only 3 points, 1 3-pointer.
As insights, we're going to take a break and come back for this inbound. And it's back in play and very, very patient as Pelham. Soft press, not a lot of pressure on it. Waiting on you to make the turnover.
There's a shot in and out.
Yeah, he hesitated on that shot. If he was going to shoot it, I wish he had taken the shot first while he was in rhythm.
Good block out by Rambis. Sam had him blocked out in there. Like I said, somebody from Thomasville's got to penetrate and kick. Reggie, in and out, boy. His shot drops. He's going to be on fire. There's a block by Perry. But somebody's got to help him out. He gets the block, and nobody's blocking out. Everybody's standing around watching him do a highlight reel.
Well, we got an offensive foul?
You got an offensive foul.
Look. And they tried to calm him down, and Reggie pushed his teammate away.
Yeah, that was a bad call. It was a bad call because the defender was trying to move in a position to block him. And the referee just called a charge simply for the fact that Reggie was moving forward.
9-3. That's two fouls on Reggie.
And Reggie went to the referee to try to argue his point.
Yeah, that's when his teammate tried to push him away, and Reggie pushed him. They're going right to the basket. They're going right to the basket.
And Reggie has two fouls, so he has to be careful.
11-3.
He has two. He has two offensive fouls.
While they're making these substitutions, we're going to take a break and come back.
Thomasville still's got to find something offensively. Reggie's in there hammered.
And one.
He's in there getting hammered. The whistle comes late, but they still give him the points.
And one. It was a long time. It's been almost five. Oh, now we got Coach John Hamilton over there. Pelham, he's fussing. Needed that one, Reggie, to get him. They hadn't hit a jump shot since Quinterius hit that three out the corner. That was almost four and a half minutes ago.
Yeah, 11s.
Playing man-to-man is what they play. I was curious to see what the foul trouble they were getting in the first quarter, if they were going to come out the man and drop into a zone. But that has not been what we saw.
Thomasville guards have got to help him out.
Well, Thomasville's guards ran down the floor. It wasn't anybody even passed the ball to.
They've got to create some penetration to draw those defenders away from Reggie. Because when Reggie catches the ball, three people on him, that's what they got to do. They got to draw the heat. Number 21. Is that the kid that they brought up from the JV squad and said to hit some shots?
Don't know, because I don't have him on my roster.
He just came off the bench. He was at the end of the bench. There's a run. And they.
Oh, they put a little trap in. Oh, he looked uncomfortable out there in the corner.
Yeah,
Reggie got. I like him being aggressive, though.
He's got to be careful. He's got to be careful because the referee is looking right at him.
And that's the referee who called the two
offensive fouls on him. Reggie with the three. There it is.
Yeah.
Oh, he's heating up, folks. That's the video game we used to say.
Ooh. And that was a big three. That made the score 12-11. Thomasville takes its first lead of the game on the three by Reggie Perry. 12-11. And it's the Insights High School Game of the Week. We're going to take a break. Follow us on Insights, INSIIGHTS, two eyes in the middle. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and on our website.
Perry with the almost no look three. Yeah, he was a victim of that first charge. It could have gone either way, but the second one, the defender was trying to get into a position to block Reggie from getting to the basket, and that's what Reggie was arguing. He said, "Hey, the guy that got one wasn't even there." And you. Referee's waiting for the clock to. Signal down to zero. Game clock new eight minutes, second quarter. Thomasville takes the lead. They started off a little lethargic and came on strong.
Titus Wright posting up strong inside there. Wow, that's a bad pass inside. He can't do anything with that.
Yeah, last year Thomasville shot too many threes when we saw them in Tallahassee, and they kind of got off the mark. It's a bad pass to Reggie. Boy, if they could just get him the ball, he was He was in position. Nice defense.
You already know that's Vontarius Woolbright. We talked about him a lot last year.
Yeah, excellent.
Good look away pass.
Excellent defense.
Good look away pass. He did not start this game. He started last year. Left-handed, handles the ball well, gets to the basket, defends well.
Excellent defense because they had him beat. They had a two-on-one, and he stopped the fast break by himself.
We wondered what had happened to him. He wasn't in the lineup the first quarter.
There's a three. You see, because he had a good look at the basket. Everybody was trying to block Reggie out and keep the front end back in, and he had an uncontested three.
And they trapped it half court.
That's over and back.
Now he has his team in there. So I don't know if it was discipline or he had been sick, but he had been starting for the last 2 years when we've seen him play. It's a noticeable difference when he comes in. The press initially was very soft in the 2-2-1. As soon as he comes back in, they start trapping aggressively at half. They get a turnover on it. They put him back at point guard. Passes goes through. Very confident handling the ball.
Yeah. And again, excellent defensive. He stopped Pelham from hitting an easy layup to make it a 15-13 game. The last time we saw him, the Thomasville guards were a little turnover prone, and they were taking some shots, some ill-advised shots, and Reggie kind of got frustrated.
Oh, my goodness. He just picked up his third foul.
No, they called that on number 10.
Did they?
Yeah, they called that on.
And he now has two. I didn't see the foul then either.
He was trying to fight around the screen, and he put his bow up high, and that's why the referee called. Equipment. See when they... Thomasville sticking with that man-to-man. There's a three.
Ooh.
Well, that was a nice three. That was a playground three.
Oh, you're right about that. That was a nice three. 6'1 sophomore, Daryl Starlins. Nailed that left-handed three on him.
There's Reggie Perry.
Boom.
And see if he can answer. He tries to answer.
Got a timeout call by Pelham. John Hamilton called that right away. It's 15-14. Thomasville will be back. The referees are getting he just explained your call. I think you had the camera on him. He showed him flexing the elbow that you just saw on number 10 on Quindarius Thomas that he threw.
Yeah. Thomas was trying to fight around the screen and tried to get his hands up, and he had that bow out. The referee called him and said, hey, you get that bow up, you're gonna get it. And so he got him.
He sure did get it now. Back in 2-2-1 press, they're going to trap him if they cross half. They're able to. If that's on Titus, that's his third.
And he's coming out. He's coming out immediately.
Yep, that's his third. They're going to shoot two. Inside's high school game of the week. Still, we're going to stay here for these free throws. And it's off. They're going to have to hit those.
Yeah, he takes him out. Titus is out. And when,
brings in Luke Wallace.
But Pelham threw kind of an alley-oop type deal. And he fouled him, got him on his hand going up.
15-15, 5:49 left in the second quarter.
Well, we knew it was going to be a tight game. It's going to come down to the team who doesn't turn the ball over, who executes. Well, you got a severe mismatch down here. All they have to do is just get the ball to Reggie up high. Reggie's down there on the player who's 6 foot. There's another three. Well, that's gone.
When he gets in that corner, that's his spot. That didn't set that press up quick enough. He's getting to the basket. Watch. Yeah.
Boy, look at that. He flies right to the basket. Pelham answers immediately. Boy, nice pass.
Wow.
Nice pass. Now, that's the pass. That's the inside pass they need to get to Perry.
And we're going to shoot these two free throws inside high school game of the boot. We'll be right back. At the line, taking the time, Luke Wallace. That was a clank. I know they kind of moved the backboard over just about 6 inches on that shot.
Is that legal?
I don't think. Maybe in Georgia. If you watch the touch on the ball, it's nice. But it clanks up there.
A little too strong on that free throw. A little too much on it. Pelham is looking for.
He called him out of bounds there?
I don't know. He had to explain to the whole world, but I couldn't hear. He had to explain his call.
Wow.
So it must have been some sort of out of bounds or some sort of turnover. There he goes.
Reggie got a little frustrated that time. He flashed across.
It's Quinterius. Reggie in the motion. See,
that's the first time somebody looked at it.
See that pass that went in there to Wallace.
That's the only one who looked at Reggie.
That pass needs to go to Reggie.
Well, Reggie's on the block, but nobody's even looking at it. They're keeping it on the perimeter.
Well, I didn't see a foul there. I saw him kind of hit the ball, but he didn't make any contact with the player.
Yeah, shooting him 1-1. We'll be right back. Reggie Perry gets his first break of the game. I think coach saw the frustration in him. He's not in the offense. They're not even looking at him. The perimeter players, the wings nor the point, are even looking. They're looking inside at Luke Wallace at the top of the free throw line.
Yeah.
But on the block, and when he flashes across, they're not even looking at him.
Yeah, Pelham is expending a lot of energy, a lot of concentration to keep Reggie. Makes them both tie game 19-18. Pelham's up by one.
Sitting directly across in front of us, the Perry family, Coach Alan Perry, Kim Perry, the fathers of Reggie. They also have another son, Alex, who's in junior college in Mississippi. We have a story done by our sideline reporter, Ms. B, on them serving and working for the men and women's basketball teams in their pregame meal.
Got it inside of Wallace.
He's going all the way to the basket.
And he does it again. Thomasville's got to do something. They got to stop the ball.
Once he gets a head full of steam, you couldn't turn him with a steering wheel. He's going to the basket. It's 21-18.
Now this makes the Pelham defense much easier now that Perry's out.
Oh, look who they identified. They identified that shooter, number 10, Quinterius.
Yeah.
They know where he is all the time now.
They know where he is.
And that motion makes them have to keep up with him. They didn't move the ball like this a few possessions ago when they had Reggie in.
Yeah. Wallace sets a high pick. And his mom is sitting right here by us. He just hit another one. She jumped up as he scored.
That's his 4-3. I thought he was a corner shooter. He's just a shooter. He shot that one up top.
Yeah, he's keeping Thomasville in the game.
Travel.
Looking for an and one. Couldn't get it.
It's the Insights High School Game of the Week. We'll take a break. We'll come back and get these two free throws. And we're back. That's the fourth. Quindarius has 12 points. He's hit four threes. 4 for 5 is what we have him for.
21-21.
Those free throws are going to come back and hurt them.
Here comes Perry. So now Thomasville brings in 21. Some confusion here. I don't know who's. Oh, they made Reggie tuck his shirt in. They made him tuck his shirt in and made him go back and tuck his shirt in. Come on, when you're the number one recruit in the state of Georgia, you know the ready. Everybody's going to be watching you. But he missed it. Just both free throws with half position.
And they get that offensive rebound again.
Pelham keeps the ball. Tie game, 21-21, with 2 minutes to go.
Trying to get to that rim, boy.
Boy, there he goes.
I told you.
That's the kind of kid that Mike Gillespie used to love. Gillespie would put four of those kind of kids on the floor and just let them go wild and drive teams crazy. Boy, the Pelham crowd yelling defense in the Thomasville's own home court. You hear more defensive chants than anything.
And they're on both sides of the gym.
Yes, sir. One minute, 58 seconds. Thomasville. There's a nice pass on the inside. But boy, if he'd have gone square up.
Well, if he shot on the same side of the basket that he caught the pass on.
Yeah, trying to do a TV move.
I see how crucial that was that they sent Reggie back out of the game to put his shirt tail in.
Yeah.
He's been over there a minute and a half game time.
Yeah, it was two.
Nice move. And.
Oh, they called a travel. Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
No, it looked like two steps.
Wow.
It looked like one, two, and shoot. And he was fouled on the shoot.
Changed the press. 1-2-1-1. They changed the press.
Timeout, and Pelham's coach immediately gets a timeout.
Immediately saw that they had changed the press. That wasn't what they had been working on. He said, I need to get them over here right now.
Get them over here.
Right now. Insights, High School Game of the Week. We'll take a break during this timeout, but we'll be back to make sure that you don't miss 1 second of this thriller here in Thomasville, Georgia.
Rat now. All right, we're back.
Oh, they came out and lined up four across in a 1-4 offensive set. They're going to see how they line up. They're in a 1-2-1-1. So if you're in a man-to-man right away, you would anticipate them trying to throw a long pass. 23-21, 1:32 left. But there's a man already back. So probably they're going to set a cross screen and come to the ball over here in one of the short corners. There's a screen. Too long. Throw over the top. Ooh.
He goes right to the basket again.
Yeah, and got the free throw.
Draws a foul.
Right to the free throw line. That's number one. DeJuan Jones.
Like I said, Gillespie.
We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. And it's their leading scorer. He's averaging almost 15 points a game, and he's getting to the rack at will.
He's aggressive. Goes right to the. Right to the hole.
Already made a free throw. They missed four in a row. They extend the lead 24-21.
That was right on the money.
Whoa, that's the first time they made two in a row.
25-21, Pelham. Hornets stinging the Bulldogs.
See what I mean by swinging the ball now?
They're
looking inside,
turnover.
But they're not looking to pass
turnover.
It to Reggie.
Wow, turnover. Turnovers are killing them. And Pelham goes right to the glass. You're going to get a reach foul on. Thomasville's going to shoot. Minute 5 to go.
25-21. Didn't take his time on that.
Reggie with a nice move, and he's fouled.
And he's fouled. Reggie at the line.
Had a nice rebound. Well, that really helps Thomasville because they're struggling. They're turning the ball over. And they can't work it inside.
They're trying to run him in that short corner, but they're not getting the ball to him in that short corner.
24-25. Turnover. Almost.
Whoa, Reggie. I ain't gonna give him a check. You knew that was coming. Reggie, you knew that, and you fouled him. Now, you had some other fouls earlier.
Yeah.
That I didn't think were as bad as that one. Oh, his mom is on it. Oh, his mom is standing up. Mom, and if you turn to Reggie a little more, you'll see the parents. They got both of them standing up.
Yeah, I see them.
But the mom, she's calling that Reggie. She's not calling that the referees. They're calling that Reggie. And that's three.
Look at his mom. Mom's in. Where she had about a 45-foot belt.
She was an outstanding track athlete at Florida A&M University.
His dad's still up.
Dad usually laid back, kind of like what you see but that's the most aggressive. I mean, that's the first time I've seen that response in him. I'm not real upset about it. I think he got a little overboard. I kind of like the emotion myself. I don't like the coach. He's on somebody. Reggie is. He and one of his teammates. I don't like that exchange.
Yeah,
I don't like that.
Yeah, don't beat up on your teammates.
And he sent all of them to the locker room. See that? They're still at it. Mm-hmm. I didn't like that exchange.
Yeah.
Wow. So I don't really know what's going on now over at the scores table.
I think there's some debate on the free throw, who's supposed to be, well, no, we got it straight. Yeah, in a tight game like this, there's a steal, Thomasville, they can get back in it. And they are, they're right back in it. Down by one, down by a bucket, by a three-pointer, timeout. You can't implode.
You're right. Insights High School Game of the Week. We'll be right back.
Thomasville came up with a big turnover right there. Keeps him in the game. Reggie, he's been frustrated all game, but he's got to realize that's the whole game plan of the other team is to keep the ball away from him.
Exactly.
And he can't fall into that trap. He fall into the trap that they cut him off that time. That looked like a travel.
Oh, good block.
Yes, Thomasville pushes it up court. There's a foul.
Yes, it was.
Wow, Thomasville can close the lead with two free throws here.
Now we had a change in momentum there. Thomasville responded to the foul and what happened on the bench. The team came out a lot more fired up, a lot more aggressive and running the floor there.
Yeah.
And they're making their free throws.
Yeah. And I understand Reggie's frustration. You know, he's calling.
You can't respond that way, though.
Yeah, he's calling for the ball.
Ooh, he didn't get to the rim that time.
Pelham's gone out of sync. Boy, he just powers it in. He's not going to be denied.
He gets to the rim at will.
Thomas here with a three. Shoots him out the gym. Tie game. Everybody in the crowd was waiting on that one. 5 seconds, four. He's headed to the rim again. 3-2. And he's going to get an offensive foul. No, he's going to get it.
No, he got offensive foul.
He got offensive foul.
Oh, yeah, he's standing in the free. Watch. He doesn't know that he's not shooting. Watch. He doesn't know.
Yeah, that was an offensive foul all day. He lowered his head. He lowered his head to protect the ball. It could have gone either way.
The scores table doesn't know what's going on.
He lowered his head to protect the ball, and referee called it. 0.8 seconds. Thomasville is off the mark.
Look at Coach. He's really on him. I don't know why. It was 8/10 of a second there to get a shot off.
What could he have done?
Yeah, that's pretty much what I was thinking. But this Insights High School Game of the Weekend. Right now, we're at halftime. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back.
All right, how many is that?
With this one right now, 11. 10.
You're going to watch.
I'm sorry, I did not mark this one. It's 11.
11. You're going to watch the halftime show live for some of our viewers. Those of you who are watching the live stream.
I was hoping our sideline reporter got some of what was going on the bench over there, but they did not.
We got a nice little contingent watching, a few of you all watching.
Okay.
Want to say hello? Good game.
Much better game than I thought we were going to have. Even though both had real good records, I wasn't expecting them to be in the game like they are. This is the second time we've had a coach take the play, tell the player to leave the bench and go to the locker room. We had that with the girls game.
Yeah. And his parents were livid. He kind of. And you could see it building. He was calling for the ball, getting frustrated, calling for the ball. And we even said it a couple of times, hey, they need to work it down there into him. But, you know, you got to understand Pelham's game plan is don't let Reggie catch the ball. Just keep him from scoring, don't let him catch it.
Yeah, that's the game plan, but he's been open anyway.
Yeah.
And he still wasn't getting the ball. And that presented a problem.
Yeah.
But the frustration, that was the most obvious foul that he's made to date.
Maybe he's been hanging around Coach Grage a little too long. So maybe getting a little less Grage, as we called it.
That was a little corny there, Jeff.
Okay. I was just saying, yeah, we said maybe he needs to get some Grage, you know.
We had said you said you wanted him to be more aggressive.
Not more frustrated, just more aggressive.
But I like him a whole lot better how he's playing today.
Yeah.
He's using some of that potential. I mean, once he decides to go baseline, he has an array, an assortment of moves he can use. He's shooting. He has such a nice touch on the ball. I told you now, depending on how he develops.
Yeah, but he.
You could see him in the right situation.
He's going to look back at the film and see, you know, clearly the defensive player didn't have position when they called the offensive foul on one of them. The other one could have gone either way. But Kent, like you said, you just gotta keep playing. And that's what his mom and dad were over there yelling. I'm glad she's sitting at the top. Not like where my mom would have been sitting down there behind the bench and like would have grabbed you by the collar and snatched you into the crowd. And start wailing away on you. My mom, they would have had to call Child Protective Services.
Or something, huh?
Or something. My mama would have taken a purse strap, taken a purse and strapped me right there with the purse.
Yeah, I know. You say the camera shut down. Huh? She said the camera is shut down.
At the reboot. Here comes Reggie, looks.
Last one out the locker room.
Yeah, it's like he's taking a look. Got him a little water. He's all right. Don't look up there. Don't make eye contact with mom. That's all you got to do. Just look the other way. Don't look up at mom. Just don't look at dad.
We'll come back at the 5-minute mark.
Yes, sir. In 30 seconds. I really wish some of you Insights viewers who are watching on the stream, some of these people would just sit down. They just keep walking. There's no other position for me to tape from. They just walk it back and forth. I wish they really would just sit down. I just want to yell, sit down somewhere.
Oh, Miss B had a stick like a cane. She was keeping them from walking in front of her last time.
Think, oh, my gosh, it's just. Okay, here we go. All right, and we are back.
Insights High School Game of the Week, and we're back. 5 minutes left before the tip-off. We were trying to find out more about what happened. We've had these emotional disagreements, and what we've been able to find out from our sideline reporter is that they're trying to tell us don't call their name. The sideline reporter found out that during the game, I mean, when the tech happened, the player was on Reggie about that was an unnecessary call, getting that technical, and that he had to maintain his composure. Reggie didn't like being told that.
And especially by a teammate.
Especially by the teammate. So the teammate didn't back down. So before it escalated, coach was like, he sent two assistant coaches to take them to the locker room and get it resolved and get it off, you know, out of public view, which was a good move before it escalated and ended up being something worse than what it looked like. I mean, we all have situations that things happen in families and between teammates and everything else.
Yeah.
Especially with the guys. You know, they can fall out and go get some wings and be okay.
Yeah. Used to.
Yeah, well.
Used to. Now it ends up on Instagram.
Okay, well, my experience of dealing with the basketball players and the male athletes, and when they have a disagreement, they can have that disagreement and move on from it. A lot of times when we had the female athletes, we had to be a little bit, things got dragged out a little bit before it got resolved.
And you just have to be careful. The coach, you know, hey, our coach used to tell us, don't beat up on your teammates. Hey, we're on the same side here. You know, we're all fighting for the same thing. You know, let's be emotional, be passionate about it, but just be careful about, you know, don't beat up, you know, don't take it out on your teammates.
Well, as I said, these things happen.
Yeah.
And coach decided that he wanted to make sure that whatever happened, they took it in the locker room and got it resolved and got it squashed before it escalated.
And Pelham's not back on the court yet. And they're lucky. I mean, Thomasville, it seemed like, you know, after that incident, Thomasville caught fire. They were down by 6, and they came back and tied the game. 31-31.
They came back, got after it pretty good. We made that comment during the course of the game that they got a lot more emotional after that and came back running the floor, running in transition. And it became a little bit more of a playground game with both teams being pretty much the same size, with Thomasville's two biggest players sitting on the sideline due to fouls.
Yeah, you had 21 come out. The mystery man, he came in and he hit a three, and the whole gym jumped up when he hit it. And it made it 29-31, and then they came back, got a foul, hit two free throws, 31-31. So it's anybody's game at the start of the third quarter. A minute 50 away. Like you said, we knew this was going to be a good one, and it is.
It is, and Pelham returns to the floor. Minute 33 before they tip the second half off.
Yeah, Reggie's a lot looser now. He just looked over there at mom, and she's still giving him the evil eye. In Spanish, they call it the ojo, the mal ojo, the evil eye. Like I said, I'm glad my mom was a lot more involved. She was more like LeBron's mom. We want to jump out the crowd with a shoe and wail a whale.
Well, Wow, we're getting ready to get back after it, y'all. See what we have. Insights High School Game of the Week. We'll be back for the tip. Well, not for the tip-off, but we will be back for the start of the second half.
All right, we're clear. 34 seconds. Pelham is still in their warm-ups.
Okay, we're clear. What does that mean? That mean we back up?
Or No. We're in commercial. All right, stand by. We're back.
Thomasville is ready. They're on the floor on the Pelham side of the ball, ready to get this game started. We'll see exactly what that means. Both big men from Thomasville are sitting on the bench. Reggie and Titus on the bench.
Reggie, what, four fouls?
No, three.
Three.
Well, he got a tech now. I don't know if that counted as a foul or not. Sometimes a tech counts as a personal foul. I'm not sure about Georgia.
Man, immediate turnover by Thomasville.
Great steal, but he tried to do too much.
Puts across court to a three-point shooter.
Almost turned it over.
There's a good position. Yeah, nice positioning.
Good position.
Nice strong putback.
Glad to see the team jump up and cheer for him to do that, including Reggie. Okay, thank you.
Yeah. I can see it.
Yeah, they looked at me like I was crazy because I was trying to keep it from walking in front of the camera.
Yeah. It's okay, though. It's Pelham slowing it down. Pelham trying to work.
Getting to the basket.
We're going to get a body block on Sam.
Mason Mobley, our student, Dr. Arthur Wood, an academic student of the game last time we did a broadcast and last year. Jumper out the corner. Number one showed you he's not just
tie game again
to the whole man.
Bad, another Thomasville guard for the turnover.
He's getting to the basket.
Boy,
I thought that was a foul that time.
Thomasville slow on the transition.
I don't know if they were slow. It wasn't a lot. He ran by him getting to the hole now. Uh-oh. That's a block. That's a
blocking foul.
Yeah, we always like Vontarius and Quindarius. We like their guards. They keep getting better for them.
Yeah. As long as they don't turn the ball over, Thomasville.
Both of them are juniors. Yeah. Long, athletic, defensive players. He looked like he was trying to decide if he was going to make that pass or not.
Yeah, it's a simple bounce pass would have gotten it there.
Well, the pass got there. He was just trying to decide if he was going to pass it to him. That's why I was watching him go through the thought processes.
Yeah, good old-fashioned bounce pass.
1-2-1-1.
They get it. There he is. He's going
to
go.
Darius is supposed to take that pass.
He goes to the hoop again.
Come on,
he misses
out. You can handle the ball. Dribble it out. Nice move.
And foul.
To the basket, Vontarius Woolbright. We got a foul, and we got two free throws coming in Sice High School Game of the Week. We'll take a break. We'll be back to catch these free throws.
Missed the first one. They needed that. They needed that one.
Yeah, they did.
They're going to sub. I don't know what's going on again.
A lot of dialogue over there at the scores table with the referee.
No, more like a dissertation. Not dialogue. The referee explaining something like.
Into the game goes Luke Wallace. Today, Dr. Arthur Wood, an academic student of the game. He's a junior with a 3.0 GPA. Congratulations to Luke and his family for his academic success.
Nice touch on that free throw. Sinks it. Pelham at a five count, six. They get it across to that coffin corner, and they're going to throw it away.
Good try.
Good try. Thomasville with an easy three. And there it is. And they're right back in it.
That's his
third
three.
They take the lead, and they turn it over again. They turn it back over. Give Pelham an easy layup.
It's a close game now, 38-37.
Thomasville.
He was going to crank. Quindarius was going to crank that up.
Cross the court pass to the shooter.
Ooh.
He hit another. He's shooting him out the gym.
He's shooting him out of here. That's four of them he's hit.
Pelham stays patient. Doesn't panic. Number 21, like you said, the mystery man, he came in. He's carrying the Bulldogs.
That's
shots off the mark. Thomasville,
that's a bank shot.
Thomasville had position. They push it up. Thomasville shooting out the gym. They're going to get a timeout. They got to get a timeout. They don't know who to key on defensively. With Perry out of the game, they're just looking at somebody catch the ball. They don't know who to key on.
Insights High School Game of the Week. It's a timeout. We'll be back.
We're off.
Okay, baby.
He said, Coach Clayton with the intel.
Oh, yeah. Up here in the stands, they know everybody. Clifford Davis, ninth grade.
Ninth grader, number 21.
Ninth grade.
Oh, nice block. Number 20 comes in off the bench with a LeBron James.
Oh, down the middle.
And almost a dunk.
Yeah, well, they call it a dunk. That's all right. That's a doctor out the wooded academic student of the game.
He's at a four count. He almost got a five count.
Still. Yep.
Thomasville, much, much more energy. I don't know what coach said to him at halftime, but I'll take some of the bottle.
Oh, boy, 45-38. That's all right there. The freshman.
Clifford Davis.
And a child shot leader.
Boy, the future of basketball in Thomasville looking good. Clifford Davis.
He had to shoot his way off the JV up to the varsity.
He has single-handedly kept the Bulldogs in the game, not kept them in the game, has propelled them to the lead.
Wow. The way they responded, I thought he was young. They responded to his performance, he was young. I didn't think he was that young.
Pelham hadn't scored. Pelham hadn't scored in the last 2 minutes. There's a nice move. Thomasville.
By Terrence Woolbright.
There's another steal by your Arthur Woodard.
Oh, he's just going to pull up and shoot the three. He had the layup, but he pulled up to shoot the three. Oh, and he missed the dunk. He missed the dunk. And the varsity girls from Pelham are laughing.
That's never good. I got to laugh at him on that one because he was wide open. Hey.
Wide open.
He was wide open for the dunk, for the throwdown.
Oh, that's a good one.
Somebody's mom over here yelled, sit your tail down. That's why I'm laughing. Not because he missed it. Pelham brings it
My
up.
My boy was clapping his hands for the ball the whole time.
He missed it. And boy.
He's going to get a nice pass. They want him to keep shooting. Might be a little tired now. He might be a little tired now.
They tell him to get back. Yeah. Pelham's out of sync defensively. They don't know who to cover. And it goes to show you where Josh is playing a whale of a game. Two big rebounds there and two steals.
Oh, we're going a little deeper in the bench now.
They're up 49-38. Pelham hadn't hit a basket. Going on 3 minutes now that they haven't hit a basket.
18-7 run.
And again, Pelham is in the they're in that zone. Thomasville calls timeout.
Insights. High school game of the week, and it's been heating up in here. Might be cold outside, but it's hot. It's your TT in here. Insights High School game of the week. We'll be right back.
Is it that they have more energy? We're not back yet. They have more energy because of Perry not being in there, or because they're fired up?
Whatever happened. Right when he got the tech, they've been a different team ever since then. And we're back. Oh, he changed the defense. Looks like we're in a 1-3-1 by Pelham.
Yeah, Pelham switched up. Try to slow those shooters down.
Well, they switched up, tried to give them a different look, a little different coverage in that 1-3-1.
The Clifford
trap there.
Clifford Davis, they took Clifford Davis out of the game.
He was tired. He had shot his best shot.
Wow.
Good rebound there, Luke.
Another rebound. Luke gets rejected, but he had a nice rebound there. And then now he's immediately back on defense.
Leading score, getting to the basket.
Thomasville rebound. Pushes ahead to Luke.
Nice catch.
Oh,
he tried to dunk another one.
Did Luke try to dunk?
Luke tried to dunk another one. I'm not mad at you, Luke.
Luke tried to dunk. He tried to dunk on him.
Oh, that's the second time tonight.
Oh.
Put a little energy in the place, Luke.
I got to put him on the all-neighborhood team. But
Going to the rim. Oh. He passed one. That was a light foul there.
And he actually didn't need to foul him because there was no way he was going to make that the way his body was twisting and turning.
And we're shooting two. We'll be back. Gee, there goes another missed free throw. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 missed free throws is what I have.
Pelham hasn't scored.
And Titus back in the game.
Pelham hasn't scored since we were at 6 minutes and some change. See if they can break the streak here. They finally do. They're down by 10. Much different Thomasville team.
No, since that technical foul, has been a difference. 1-3-1 press. They run it a little differently. Usually the back man on the 1-3-1 covers court in the corner. Did you see him size that shot up?
And the coach was right there in his ear yelling no. The coach was right there in his ear. Boy, that's almost a moving screen by the Thomasville player was shifting down lower in the block. But that was almost a moving screen. Lucky that the referee didn't see him moving.
Vontaze gets to the free throw line. We'll stay here. He hadn't hit one yet by our records. There he is.
Look at the coach. The coach is celebrating.
Right.
Yay. The coach is clowning him. His old coach is clowning him. You finally hit one. And he's still clowning him.
Yeah, but Vontaze doesn't think that's funny. He's not sharing the gaiety of that.
He hit two.
No, he hit one. He crossed the line. He hadn't been hitting them. He already running in to get it.
Well, I want to see Mr. Clifford Davis back in the game.
Clifford needed a rest.
He's sitting up there high on the. Travel, okay.
I was wondering what they were going to call.
Because nobody touched him.
Right. We were both sitting there looking like, okay.
This is about to be the worst call of the century.
How do you beat the press in the middle? 2-4, you got to take the middle pass away.
There's Thomasville. Line it up. Pelham out of sync defensively. There. Thomasville with an easy offensive rebound. They were battling for it. They get it back in there to the big man, and he powers his way in to a jump ball.
He's a lot more physical with his moves inside now.
He sure is.
6'9", junior, Titus Wright. Last year, he was a little soft in there. He's not soft now. Might hit that.
They tip it. Pelham on the run. Pelham's gone ice cold. They needed that one.
And as you spoke.
They needed that one.
Yeah, they did.
Fourth quarter coming up here in 40 seconds.
Daryl Starling, 6'1", junior, to the hole, scores that one.
Oh, man, threw it away. That's what they can. Thomasville hadn't turned the ball over. They hadn't turned the ball over since almost the start.
They never turned around. Never turned around. Never turned around.
And Pelham right back in it. They were down by 10. Now they're down by 7.
They were trying to set up the press. They took the ball in and threw it all the way down the left of the floor.
And, boy, the Pelham crowd kicks in. Boy, that's a travesty of justice. If you let the crowd come
in. That was a foul called from behind. None of the other two officials, I actually didn't think it was much contact on that. Titus Wright at the line. Lefty, 6'9", junior. Has improved, stronger down there.
Don't let the other team come in here and out cheer you. You're yelling defense in your own home. Nice touch on the ball. Missed the second. Pelham's on the run.
8-point lead for Thomasville.
10 seconds.
They're just throwing over the top of the pressure.
4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. They get a shot off. Almost.
And we have a 51-43 point lead to the Thomasville Bulldogs. We'll come back and bring you the final quarter here on Insights High School Game of the Week. Thank you to our sponsors, Cumulus Radio, WCTV2. We appreciate you, Wooded Foundation. Insights High School Game of the Week. We'll be right back.
Perry.
Trying to see who they were going with. They brought Reggie back. Fourth quarter.
His teammates dapping him up. And then teammate who was over there and he had a little exchange with was the first one to give him some dap when the coach told him to take his warm-up off. He told him to go get him.
Hey, I tell you, that just happens all the time.
Yeah.
They actually have been on a 24-12 run since the technical foul.
So Pelham changes personnel. I don't know if that was a legal substitution. They ran a guy in and ran it back off when they saw that Reggie was coming back in the game.
Oh, he was open back door there.
Yeah. All he had to do was hit him with a simple bounce pass. Underutilized in high school basketball today. Even basketball in general. John Stockton used to be the master of the bounce pass to Carl Malone down low.
They're running their motion offense.
Like you said, they've missed two. That's almost a travel.
Oh, he was about to travel then.
Boy, Pelham battling.
Pelham battling. Kendrick Patterson, leading rebounder.
The coach was telling him, work it inside. They're trying to get Reggie fouled out of the game. They want him to jump in there defensively. Boy, almost a travel there by Thomasville.
Kendrick Patterson, 6'4", sophomore, number 14. Now that time, rather than running to the short corner, they ran him all the way through. He was able to get at least a touch. Missed him.
Oh,
bad pass. Good save.
Oh, that looked like the body got him. I've seen softer fouls.
Reggie looked at him when he made that foul because he said, you'd have called that foul on me, but you didn't call it on him.
Wow. He blocked him from behind and got him with the body. And we had a layup foul down here with
the. And we'll have to take a break. We'll be back shooting these free throws. Devon Jones, leading scorer. He's the only one to hit two free throws in a row for Pelham.
Well, he's kept the Hornets in the game single-handedly.
He has.
He's been the only person driving. He's had a couple of threes that he's attempted. But with him driving to the basket, he's been doing it for him. He misses a second. 51-46. Pelham resets.
They haven't ran DeJuan at the point guard spot, and they didn't then. They took him off the point. I was curious to see how he would operate with the ball in his hands to initiate the offense to get him to the free throw line. He actually got fouled that time.
Nice block out. Like you said, there was some contact there. Reggie a lot more content now that, like they explained to him the game plan. Hey, just keep moving. We'll get it to you. Be patient. He sets a high screen. That's over the back.
Yeah.
Now you get that call, but you don't get it on the layup.
51-46, ball in play. Did not take them long. 5:37 left in the game.
But Pelham needs a bucket here.
You know what's happening now.
They let him drive to the basket, went out of control. Reggie can't get frustrated.
Is that DeJuan able to finish that one?
Yeah.
48-51.
They ripped him from behind. Boy, the Pelham crowd goes crazy. Yelling defense. Well, Thomasville needs a basket here desperately. They can get it to him.
Finally on the block. He hadn't got many down there.
And they go. The referee gave him that one back. That was a makeup call from earlier because the guy just slid. He just fell.
Jump shot right there. Huh?
The coach and Reggie both frustrated. Like, looking out at Reggie's double teamed, almost triple teamed.
That's the gap.
That's it.
That's the gap. He was so busy concerned with Reggie.
With Reggie. Nobody back from Thomasville. And boy, an easy layup by Pelham. He misses.
Missed shot. 53-50.
Nobody from Thomasville got back on that.
Two was standing out of bounds way over here. His shoe was in the red line. Reggie must have four fouls.
Pelham 52, Thomasville 53. 3 minutes to go. The Pelham crowd yells defense.
They put Reggie on the wing now.
I couldn't even see the remnants of a foul there.
That was a light one there. Insights High School Game of the Week. We'll be right back. Oh, we took Reggie out.
We're back, and Reggie Perry out of the game. Maybe a smart move, because you may need him with a mid-three shot opportunities. Nobody's in there backing him up.
Here comes DeJuan Jones, leading scorer, trying to get back in the game.
Yeah, he's
there's something going on over there. We'll take a inside high school game of the week. We'll take a break while they resolve whatever the issue is.
One and one.
And that's what the issue was. They were trying to take the ball out of bounds. Somebody was arguing. Coach is calling the press over there, Coach Benjamin Tillman. Misses the free.
Boy, they needed that one. Now the Hornets got to jump on it. This is their opportunity. 2 minutes to go. Take the lead. Somebody's got to step up. They got a freshman on the leading score. Well, he drives to the hoop and gets the foul. That's what you do. That's what your leading scorer does. The game's on the line. He takes it to him.
We'll shoot these two free throws. We'll be back. And we're at the line. He's 3 for 4 from the free throw line by our unofficial stats. He knocks one down, ties it up. How long is Coach going to leave Reggie over there?
53-53.
Knocked them both down.
Pelham.
DeJuan Jones, unofficially, we have him for 18 points. A little bit over his average.
Pelham made a nice adjustment on defense for those shooters. Now they're vulnerable to the drive and penetrate in the middle.
Well, that's your penetrator there.
There it is. So as soon as Reggie goes out of the game, they change the defense and become vulnerable to that middle attack.
I didn't think he'd hit. Oh, he pushed him in the back. He did.
24 was trying to get position from the block out.
And we're shooting 1-1 on the other end. Inside's high school game of the week. We will be back.
Looks like the old switcheroo. I thought that they called that the foul was on Quinterius. But that I thought. They got another man at the line. Did it look? I thought. Okay. Is that what you saw?
I don't know what I saw there.
You don't know what you saw. Okay, well.
I got a little confused, which doesn't take a lot.
It looked like number two was pushed in the back. Okay. But I guess.
Boy, they put the right one at the line because he hit both of them.
He hit them both with ease. Nothing but bottom of the net, so.
Boy,
142 left. They got a lot of confidence in a freshman to be guarding the leading scorer. Thomasville's got to get back. Missed the layup. Boy, if he'd have used the glass on that one. And there's your Arthur Woodard. Scooting athlete hustling down there, disrupting the Pelham offense. Boy, if he'd have used the glass on that one, they could have taken a comfortable lead and sat on the ball.
Exactly.
Could have taken a 5-point lead with a minute and 28 to go.
I think they decided they're gonna finish this one with Reggie over there watching the rest of it.
That was off the mark.
I would say so. Across the goal.
That was being generous and hey, off the mark. Nice screen.
He's going to get to the basket. Nice tip.
There's your student athlete of the week. 50 seconds to go. Thomasville's got a 5-point lead. Pelham's got to get it. They got to get something here. They got the freshman on the leading scorer.
No,
he throws up a three.
No,
whoosh.
No.
And shoots him out the gym.
No,
woo!
No.
Woo!
No.
If I was Thomasville's coach, I'd get a timeout.
He shot that off the tee.
Thomasville needs a timeout bad.
No. He was trying to call a timeout. Ooh, he carried that.
They carry. They can't turn the ball over here. 20 seconds. They desperately need a timeout.
That's the one they want to foul.
There they go. And they did the.
That's a turnover.
They did the exact. That's why they were out of sync and out of position and weren't sure of how they were going to hold the ball. Thomasville's coach, all he had to do was call a 30-second timeout and tell him, hey, this is how we're going to execute. I saw him in trouble. I tried to help him out.
They wanted them to learn how to play through it. Oh, he looked at – not another one. Not another one. I don't believe that.
Wow.
I don't believe that. 4 seconds. He won't pass the ball. He won't pass the ball.
And he missed 60 to 59. Boy, Pelham shocks the house.
Wow.
Boy, it's going down. Pelham,
wow.
Thomasville fans. Boy,
wow.
He threw up a three and it hit backboard and went in. 60 to 59.
Wow.
Boy, an outstanding shot.
Wow. Thomasville basketball and football has some bung bunnies. Thomasville and Brooks County in football. And then we got Thomasville with Pelham in basketball.
Boy, all I can say is wow. Wow, he threw it, their leading scorer. He single-handedly.
Wow.
Single-handedly put the Hornets, put a W in their column.
Wow. Wow.
He just made the all-neighborhood team. Two huge threes. He said, I got the keys, coach. Y'all are going to go where I take you. And he took them right to the promised land. Two huge threes.
Wow.
Without hesitation.
Wow. That's all I could say on that.
I lie. You got to love it. The kid with that much heart. He's got some heart, coach.
Wow. Coach, two ill-advised shots that he threw up there.
Coach, I got to give him a scholarship. I got to give him a Pell Grant. I got to get him something. Get him book money. Get him something.
He's a winner.
Yes, sir. He that's some heart.
He's a winner. He was taking him off the dribble. We wanted to see what he could do from the perimeter. Both of them he shot, I thought he missed. He hit him off the glass and in.
Yeah.
He was even trying to draw the foul. He was falling backwards, trying to get the foul call, and it wasn't any to be made. I think he stunned everybody.
Stunned.
In there.
9 seconds. He hit two threes within 12 seconds of each other. He hit a three at 23 seconds, and then he hit that second three at 9 seconds. And the first one that went in, Thomasville got the ball and immediately went out of sync. They were not sure who was going to handle the ball in the stall, in the hold the ball game, and so they committed a turnover at half court. He got the ball, dribbled to his spot, threw it up off the glass with a fall away.
We thought those missed free throws were going to come back and actually hurt Pelham because they had missed about eight of them. Quindarius Thomas did a heck of a job for him. He hit five threes, ended up with 19 unofficial points. But the freshman, Clifford Davis, came off, and we had him for 12. He had four threes. He did a good job.
Excellent job.
Story is DeJuan Jones, the leading scorer, averaging 14.7 points a game, the 5'11 senior, by our tally. Hit 24 points.
Wow.
And
two huge threes.
He hit 10 points in a row.
Yeah.
He just carried them. Just
he said, I'm gonna take you to you, coach. I got the keys wherever I got the keys and y'all are riding with me.
Absolutely. And coach was okay with it. And you commented earlier about having the ninth grader on it.
Yeah. You got a freshman on the leading scorer on the team. You got to get somebody else on him. I mean, I'm not telling him how to coach, but just, you know, through years of experience, that's the last person who a rookie on the best team, the best scorer on the team.
Well, all I can say, Coach Tillman knows these guys a lot better than I do. I would imagine that what he was doing was he was a little quick. He had rested. He had came back in the game. and let him go at him. I think there were some lessons that were intended to be taught to this team tonight by Thomasville. I don't think Coach Tillman was real happy with the lack of effort. You saw a much different team the second half in terms of the effort, and especially the third quarter in terms of what they did in the game. And I think that he was trying to send a message. That's how I take a lot of what was going on tonight. And he wasn't real happy, evidently, with Reggie, and benched him and let him sit out the rest of the game.
Yeah.
And it was.
Yeah, he wasn't happy with that exchange.
No, he was not.
And it's good, like you said, it's a good coaching move. And he played who he played. And, you know, even without the number one player in the state, they only lose by 1 point at the buzzer with 9 seconds to go.
At the buzzer, you know, and I don't know all of what's going on. It's interesting, the dynamics of the team and what's going on. And then a coach, you know, trying to make sure that he has control of his team. And what will happen is that the team will continue to develop, continue to get better, and get ready to make a run, because this is a team that many people are expecting to get to the state championship round and to be competitive in it.
I'll make the same call that I made with Lincoln last year. If they don't win state,
there you go.
No,
the Jeff Walker philosophy.
No, they have the horses. They have the team. I haven't seen a lot of teams in Thomasville, but, you know, looking at this Pelham team, they're scrappy. They've got grit. They take the ball to the basket. They play together. I mean, they hustle on defense. And you got a kid whose heart is just I will not lose.
I agree with that. And they never wavered in what they were doing.
Never wavered.
Pelham didn't. They stayed true to what they do. They continued to work at it. Thomasville changed. They threw some things at. Well, Thomasville stayed in their man-to-man, but they've changed their offense a little bit, ran a little bit more motion. They actually were in a real good position to be able to knock down some threes. The freshman did a tremendous job coming off the deep bench and knocking down some deep threes for him. He's going to continue to develop for him and give him some additional help. I thought Dr. Arthur Woodard, academic student of the game, I thought Luke did a real good job. He had a real nice tip. Active around the rim, tried to dunk a couple more. So I'm sure that in the offseason he's going to work to get that extra
inch.
1 point quarter and a quarter inch on his vert to be able to throw it down a lot easier. But, again, this was a very exciting game to watch and
a very exciting
Thomasville team.
I just can't say enough about Jones. Those two threes. I mean, I was stunned. I was stunned when he hit the first one with 23 seconds to go, nothing but net falling away. The coach just, you know, looked at him, and then he got up. Thomasville turned it over. He said, "Give me the ball." They gave him the ball. He dribbled right back to the same spot, threw it up off the glass, 9 seconds to go. Storybook. I mean, whoever's watching this on the internet, and who the fans are going to watch this on the replay, you're going to see a kid that will not be denied. Coaches, you should be taking a look at this kid. Don't let him get away. All the coaches in this area, if you let this kid get away, I'm telling you, this Jones kid, he's a player.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
All I could say was wow.
Yeah. All the coaches under the sound of my voice.
Wow.
He's on the all-neighborhood team, starting guard.
Wow. Wow. That he kind of took my breath away a little bit with that. Wow. And we're really, again, we appreciate the relationship that we have here at Thomasville High School. We're able to talk to the football coach, Coach Grage, and we're able to meet earlier with the former Mobley able to meet with him earlier today, and our athletic director Chris Merritt from here. You know, Thomasville has always been very hospitable towards us, and we appreciate it. They do whatever they can to make the broadcast a simple job for us.
Yes.
And You know, make you feel like you're at home.
They're at the door waiting for us when we get here, so that you don't have to explain anything. And they say, "Hey, come on." So thank you, Thomasville. Outstanding administration here in Thomasville.
Wow. We really appreciate it. And we're looking forward to being able to do some additional things here in Thomasville. And as Insight's High School Game of the Week comes to a close, again, our intent is to be able to bring some additional publicity to these young men and women that are playing for these respective high schools in our area, show the teams, the high schools, what's going on in the high schools, give these student-athletes a chance to be able to sit home, watch themselves on television, get that microwave popcorn, get something to eat, be able to take the game tapes and send them to potential college coaches, to their family members who aren't here. And we just appreciate you allowing us to be in your home. And this is the coach, Mickey Clayton, and my partner in crime, Jefferson Walker, the 22nd. We appreciate you. And this is Insight's High School Game of the Weekend. We're signing off.